It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on. Candy fresh, gon' show love, get your shine on. It's that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on. Candy fresh, gon' show love, get your shine on.
Miss Shannon.
And I am Roxy. Welcome to another special edition of Candy Fresh.
Yes. And if you're a regular viewer of Candy Fresh, you're probably going, these are not our normal hosts.
No.
Yeah, don't worry. Nothing's wrong. We are actually here to celebrate a very special occasion. It is the 1 year anniversary of Candy Fresh programming.
Oh, yeah.
Give it up, everyone.
As you can see, we will be stepping in to interview your original co-hosts, Sanni Brown and Miss Brit, as well as executive producers Aaron Price and Bianca B. Lovely Rhodes.
Yes, give it up for them. And it wouldn't be an episode of Candy Fresh if we didn't have our amazing musical guest. Tonight, you will get to see Destiny Roberts.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
And we'll also have a performance from the amazing La Vie Boheme. Give it up, bro.
Oh, yeah.
And, of course, holding it all together, put your hands together for our DJ, Miss Brit on the ones and twos.
Woo-woo.
There we go.
We have a lot to cover tonight, so please sit back and relax and enjoy another edition of
Candy Fresh.
Candy Fresh got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on.
And we are back here at Candy Fresh. I am Miss Shannon, and I feel very intimidated because I get to do the first interview of someone who normally does the first interview. So if you have seen the show before, I know you are very familiar with Miss Sanni Brown. Yes, yes. Sanni, a.k.a. Cutie Booty Radio, a.k.a. radio host, a.k.a. mother, a.k.a. volunteer, improver. I think I read astronaut somewhere in your bio somewhere. Okay, maybe I made that one up.
No, I am on the weekends.
Okay, that
it's
works.
A part-time
right. You
show.
Would look good in the astronaut suit.
They ain't going to let the little ponytail hang out the top. If I can't have no ponytail game at the top,
it might not be aerodynamic.
No,
I agree with
not.
You. And you are normally one of the primary hosts here at
yes,
Candy Fresh, along with our DJ tonight, Miss Britt.
Whoop, whoop. Give it up for the DJ. Give it up for the DJ.
Now, how did you begin your journey to get to Candy Fresh?
Ooh, wow, that's a good question. Well, I'm a radio host at 89.9 KMLJ, and I've been looking around for different gigs. You work in entertainment, so you know how
right?
that goes.
Yes.
And I called up Bianca a few months before Candy Fresh even came into play. And I was like, man, Bianca, it's hard. What's going on with the TV scene, with the radio scene? Hook me up. Tell me something. And so she gave me some tips on what I could do. She was like, you can make your own stuff on YouTube. You can
right.
become a content creator, you know. And I was like, all right, well, I guess I keep grinding until something comes up. So then I see something on Facebook that's like, there's this brand new TV show. And it's called Candy Fresh. And it's actually by a group called Crown Lens Media Group.
Right.
And they are auditioning for two shows. One of them was Reminisce Over You, and the other one was Candy Fresh. And I was like, oh, yeah, I just had a conversation with B. It's going down. And so we went through the audition process. I was kind of nervous, but here we are a year later.
Congratulations.
Yay.
So you do so many things. You're so multi-talented. So regarding this show, how do you find balance between this project and the other projects that you have?
I am a professional napper.
I like that.
Yeah. I think like I said, if you, I think everybody in here has to learn how to nap a little bit. I think just the way the world is.
The audience is agreeing
with
you.
Yeah, yeah. I think
they're very pro nap. Yeah, you can see.
Yeah. I just think the way the world is, you know, a lot of people have 2 and 3 jobs, and a lot of people are balancing parenthood and their careers, and you just have to really know how to power nap.
So, okay, we're up to episode number 10. Today we are actually filming on the actual 1 year anniversary.
This morning when I opened up my Facebook, I had a picture that I put up last year. And I was like, it's really to the day. It's actually a year today.
Congratulations for that. Yeah, congratulations. As we move forward to this next year, what is the thing that you know I have to accomplish during this next year with Candy Fresh?
Growth. Okay. I really want to see this show grow. I think a lot of people, when they see, because there's tons of events that are happening over the weekend, and I think people are like, what is this Candy Fresh stuff about? But at the end of every show, people are like, oh, man, this was dope. I got to come back and experience this. And I think for us, it's just getting the word out, because even though people are a little apprehensive when they first come, they always leave happy. And we have a lot of word of mouth, which is the best advertisement. So y'all should be tweeting and Facebooking and Instagramming. But
Snapchatting.
Yeah. Oh, that is the new one. I'm a little slow on that one.
That's okay. I'll help you out. It has good filters.
Okay. Okay. All right. But yeah, the biggest thing this year is growth and just getting the word out and people feeling comfortable being able to come here and get their shine on.
Well, you have to multitask into, as we talked about all of the social media, you multitask into your Cutie Beauty Radio and all these other things. So how do you bridge the gap between all these different projects?
I guess the bridge between the different projects is there are things that I want to do. funny story behind Cutie Beauty Radio. I have a daughter, and she struggles with self-esteem like the rest of us ladies. And I had terrible self-esteem when I was younger. And so there was this one time I was fussing at her about doing dishes or something. And later on, I came downstairs and I saw her with the word failure on her arm. And so I ain't like that. I just didn't like that. So I was like, she has to see me be a woman that has healthy self-esteem, a confident woman, a woman going for her dreams. And so I came up with Cutie Booty Radio because my mom always called me Cutie Pie. People are always calling me cute. And it kind of irritated me because I'm like, no, I'm beautiful. I'm a goddess. Don't call me cute.
I want to be sexy.
Cute. That's like, I ain't no chicken nugget, you know? I'm a chicken tender, you know what I mean? I mean, get the name right. So I came up with Cutie Booty Radio, and I know it sounds silly, and it's like, why would a grown woman call herself that? But it is for my daughter so that she can see. Even if the name sounds a little silly, it's my mama standing up, and if she can be a confident woman and go for her dreams, then gosh darn it, so can I.
I appreciate that. I think everybody should give a round of applause to that. We do that. So as we get ready to round up this first interview after our first anniversary, tell me your favorite moment of the last year.
My favorite moment was a couple of episodes ago. It was when DJ Mickey Breeze was here and everybody was just having fun. We were so caught up in dancing at the end that Bianca was like, hey, we got to wrap this up. We got to clean stuff up. That was the moment for me where I knew Candy Fresh was making people happy, and especially with all the tough times that's going on right now, I'm proud to be a part of a project that's really putting some happiness and some good energy out there in the community. So,
and Sanni, we appreciate everything that you've done. We appreciate this first year. I know it was a lot of work for everybody, and we look forward to growing with you into the next year. So we are now going to move on to our next one. Our next interview when we come back will be with our DJ and your co-host, Miss Brit. Everybody, we'll be back very soon with Candy Fresh. Give it up,
y'all.
Candy Fresh got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine.
Yes, I am Roxy, and right now, on the stage with us, we have the co-host of Candy Fresh, Miss Brit. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. It feels so amazing to be standing right next to you. How do you feel being on the other side of the table?
This is very strange. I don't know what's happening 95% of today. Yeah. But I'm very excited that we made it to a year.
Of course, you're doing your thing. I'm definitely excited for you to be here tonight.
Thank you. Likewise, welcome.
Thank you. I appreciate it. So, originally, you're a co-host. When you first started, you went through the audition process. How was that, and where do you think you've grown since you're celebrating your 1 year anniversary today?
For me, one of the hardest things to do, because I started in radio, transitioning into television, I used to always speak to our viewing audience as if they were a listening audience. So I'm like, to all you listening at home, and they're like, no, they're watching you. So just, you know, changing my language and being mindful that there's a different medium. You know, I don't get to roll my eyes or giggle behind the scenes like I can in radio. So it was a big transition, but it was such a blessing to have a team who was very supportive of me being my full and authentic self and not trying to make me into something that I'm not. And that was, I think, the most powerful thing, is to see especially so many Black women running television.
Exactly. Give it up for that.
That was very affirming. So that helped to get rid of a lot of my nerves.
Oh, yeah. So today you're going to be DJing the show. What made Miss Brit get behind the DJ equipment?
Well, it started because I do radio. I already have to prepare mixes.
Okay.
So I was already doing selecting before, kind of, you know, the plug and play or blending mixes together. But about a year ago, or a little less than a year ago, actually, I decided to kind of step my game up, become an actual DJ there in hip hop, because my show on the radio is primarily hip hop. There are very few women that come on as MCs, as DJs. There are some awesome women within the Twin Cities that are doing their thing.
Yes, sir.
But there could be a whole lot more of us. And so instead of being a speculator or a commentator, I've decided to get active and get in the game. And, you know, if I wanted something in the industry to change, I decided I was going to change it.
Yeah, exactly.
Myself.
Wow. Give it up for Ms. Britt. That is so amazing. So what is next for you, Ms. Britt?
A lot. You know, first I got to make it through tonight. We just
right,
pray
of course,
about it.
You know,
God is good all the time. But, you know, I have a lot of really great things on the horizon. I'm coming out with a book of poetry, which I'm really excited about. A few of my pieces are actually getting ready to be published in the next episode. See, the medium is hard. The next edition of the St. Paul Almanac will publish a few of my poems. And then my book will follow probably sometime next year.
Wow.
I've been asked to do a spoken word tribute to Prince.
What?
So I'm actually working.
That's amazing.
So I'm doing this piece called This Thing Called Life. And there's like a video documentary to go with it. The Twin Cities. Oh, gosh. Caroline. The Twin Cities Daily Planet is going to be publishing this later on this summer, so I'm really looking forward to honoring the Purple One.
Of course. That's amazing. Give it up for that opportunity, you guys. So my next question to you, Ms. Britt, if there are some younger audience and younger women that are watching the show, what would you tell those young girls that probably want to follow in your footsteps?
Two things. One, you can do anything that you want to do, but that doesn't mean that you should do everything. So really deciding what it is that you want, and it can be multiple things. For me, it's a lot of different things, but the key to that is synergy, making sure that you're able to balance, that these things can tie into one another, or that these different spaces support your work. And part of that is bringing your full self into every space. So for a lot of us, we're told, you know, DJs look this way, you got to be a guy, you know, or you got to look like this to be on TV, or talk this way, or radio has to be like this. And for me, I felt differently, and I thought that my differences would make me unique, and that's why I should be in the spaces that I'm in. So bringing my full and authentic space and not allowing anyone to project what I should be or should do was also a key to making it here, is being unwavering in who I am.
That's amazing. I love that answer. What are you, Ms. Britt, most excited about tonight?
You know, I'm really excited for our performances. We have Boheme and Destiny Roberts. I'm big fans of both of them. I'm also excited. It's really awesome to be able to sit back and watch. So even watching you and Ms. Shannon at the start of the show, it's like, that's what I look like.
Right.
And it looks good from this angle. Y'all look good doing it.
Thank you.
I'm excited to celebrate, you know, from auditioning and being very silly in my audition to making it to a full year as a television host. I didn't see this happening. So the whole thing, celebrating with everybody in the audience, and I'm excited about the whole thing.
Well, we're excited to have you back here at the DJ booth.
Thank you. Thank
I
you,
am
thank
Roxy, you. And this is Miss Britt. Up next, we have Bianca B. Lovely Rhodes being interviewed by Miss Shannon. Thank you so much, and this is Candy Fresh.
Candy Fresh got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on.
Yes.
I can't believe
it. Oh my goodness. Welcome back to Candy Fresh. I am Ms. Shannon, one of your fill-in co-hosts this evening, because we are again celebrating the one-year anniversary of Candy Fresh. So thank you so much for joining us. So let's take a second to say thank you to our studio audience that makes this so amazing. So thank you so much for you guys. And I have the pleasure of speaking to one of the co-creators of this amazing program, Bianca Rhodes, aka B Lovely, aka your new nickname, Boss Lady, because you boss everybody in this building around. And I will tell you, I very rarely feel inadequate when I go places. But this evening, I feel incredibly inadequate because I have my tallest shoes on and I look like a Smurf.
I am not feeling this. But I got flat.
This is too much. You need to stand
I
down
try.
There.
Try.
So we are up to 1 year here at Candy Fresh.
Yes.
Tell me how this started for you, Bianca.
All right. So once upon a time in a taco shop.
Wow.
Once upon a time in a taco shop. So me and my homeboy, Aaron Price, of 12 years. Give it up. Give it up. The homies. The riders.
Yes.
Had reconnected because we went to college and all that kind of stuff. And
life gets in the way.
Life. Mm-hmm. And so I saw him on Facebook, and he had an article about him doing video at his job.
Right.
And it was this awesome picture with a similar camera that we have here at St. Paul Neighborhood Network. And I was like, wait a second. What? He doing video? So I was like, okay, we need to reconnect, and I need to learn about your life. You need to learn about mine, and maybe we should do something and see what happens.
Because you had a number of projects that were going on before you started this. I know you were quite busy, because I've known you a long time, too.
Yes,
so you were working it.
Yes.
So what made you go, you know what, this is the project that I need to put my effort and my heart into right now?
Yes, so I started working at the St. Paul Neighborhood Network, who I had been a part of for 10 years prior to accepting the staff position. And everyone already had their thing. So it was like, wait a second, I don't have a thing. I need to have a thing.
Right.
And so Candy Fresh kind of was a situation where a long time ago, I think I was fresh out of college, and I had this show called That's What's Up, which was Martrell Brown, who's one of my hosts. He's in the back.
Yeah.
But he was one of my very first hosts, and it was just me, like, setting up the cameras, doing everything, and he was just in front of the camera.
Right.
And we had a host and some guests, and that was it.
Okay.
And so I told Aaron, like, this is what I got. This is what I had been doing.
It was a foundation.
Yes. And he was like, what? Okay, let's do this. Let's add this and maybe a little bit of this. And at first I was like, that's a lot, bro. Bro, how we gonna pull this off, bro? It's like, don't worry about it. We got this. So we had auditions, which was a lot of fun. And actually, the auditions was similar to this.
Okay.
So they had to interview us.
Right.
So we didn't think how it was gonna be a little different. It's like, yeah, we're going to have them ask us some questions. Wait a second. Hold on. They got to ask us some questions. So this was how their auditions were.
Okay.
Was they were the ones who decided to ask us the questions, and we had to be a guest. So.
And you know, if it started in a taco shop, it was going to be spicy.
It was going to be spicy.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And so now 10 spicy episodes.
Yes.
Later, what are you hoping to accomplish as you move forward?
Oh, my goodness. I just wanted to continue to grow. Like I said, just even having these wireless mics, y'all. Okay? Just having these Candy Fresh lights.
Yeah.
around the DJ. So that's just giving you a little taste of what's to come. So little by little, it's just going to get more and more super dope, and that's what I hope.
And I do like the variety. You bring in so many different performers, so many different community members.
Yes.
The fact that you're able to move the show from location to location, that is a lot of work.
That wasn't the original idea, but Aaron was like, we're going to make it happen. I call him Captain Make It Happen. He said, I know St. Paul Neighborhood Network is building this studio. We're not going to wait. Let's see what we can do. And so it has been a community effort. It has been the homies. It has been the community, and just supported us. And surprisingly, with little to no budget. So all those beautiful places donated their time and their service to Candy Fresh.
And congratulations for you moving that to move.
Thank you.
That is a good mountain to move.
Thank you. Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, man. So, what do you think being up here in front of the lights? Ooh, how you feeling?
Yeah.
Right?
You'd be like, did I set them up right? Like, you really don't know until you in front of them. Yeah. So, it's different.
So, tell our viewers how they can get involved as we move forward here at Candy Fresh.
Man, well, social media, everything is at Crown Lens Media Group or at Crown Lens. Also, St. Paul Neighborhood Network, spnn.org. They always post this as an event. Follow Crown Lens Media on Facebook. Follow Sonny Brown, Cutie Booty Radio. Follow Miss Brit. Follow Essence Jones, because she's going to be coming out with some programming. Like, everybody is going to be coming up. 2016, 2017.
Well, I am so excited to see you guys grow. And thank you so much for making me
You're
a part
welcome.
Of this, too. So I appreciate you.
Yes.
And next time, I'll find a step ladder.
I'm trying.
I'm going to find a step ladder. It'll
I'm
be good.
Trying.
All right, all right, all right.
I love you.
All right, everybody, please give it up for co-creator of Candy Fresh, Bianca Rose.
This is how we do it.
Thank y'all.
One of the hardest working women I know. All right, and when we come back, we are going to come back with the co-creator of Candy Fresh, Mr. Aaron Price. So in the meantime, please give it up for our DJ, Miss Britt.
This is how we do it.
That Candy Fresh got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on.
Wow, that was amazing. I am Roxy, and up here on stage with us, we have the executive producer, or one of the executive producers of Candy Fresh, Mr. Aaron Price. How are you doing today?
I am doing exceptionally well.
Are you? You yes, look ma'am. Exceptionally good.
Oh, well, well. Well, thank you. I tried.
Of course. You know, how do you feel being on the other side of this and celebrating your one-year anniversary with Candy Fresh?
You know, it's interesting because I've always been on the other side.
I know.
I've always been in the background. You know, I never went to take too much credit for this. You know? So it's like I got a chance to see something that I sat down with and burned the midnight oil with, like, for weeks, and then turn around and be like, wow. We're here.
Right. Look at this. Look at God.
I know, right?
So you're kind of like a Renaissance man. You have like so many titles and so many jobs. How did you originally get started with Crown Lens?
How did I get started with Crown Lens? Oh, that's interesting considering that me and Bianca created it. Yeah, right. It was kind of crazy because, you know, when I originally got out of school, I started working. And then I started doing film work for my job, and then Bianca called me up and was like, hey, you know, see, you got some things going on. I happen to be doing this. You know, we should collab. Like, you know, I'm always down to collab. You know, let's try something. So she told me about this show she was doing, and I was like, you know what? You know what would be dope if we added a DJ, right? If we added dancers. If we, you know, like everything you see today is pretty much what was in my brain when it happened, right?
Right.
So, and like she said before, she's like, no, bro, that's a lot, you know? But I'm like, we can make it happen.
Exactly, made it
just
happen.
Just trust in your boy.
Well, they definitely trust in you because this set looks amazing. Thank you so much for allowing us to be here tonight, right? So, of course, Mr. Aaron Price, you have your mother here tonight, right?
I sure do, and I also have my brothers in the house.
Oh, brothers, too. Well, hello, mother and brothers. Did you originally think that Candy Fresh would make it to its 10th episode?
You know, in this business, nothing's ever sure, right? I think there was, like, shaky moments in the beginning, and for me, it was like, okay, just kind of like, I know a lot of you guys are still trying to get to know me. Like, who is this guy, Aaron Price? I don't know him, right? So it was kind of like the same, even when we started this, you know, even with the people that we have, like, you know, who is this guy?
Yeah.
I mean, we know Bianca, you
right?
know, but who is this guy? And for me, it was kind of interesting because I had to try to build trust and let them see that, you know what, that woman has trusted me for 12 years.
Exactly.
You know, so if you trust her, you can trust me. I'm not going to hurt you. But, yeah, I mean, hey, I did not know it would get to this point, but I felt like it could get to this point if we just continue to be consistent.
Of course.
And consistency pays.
Exactly. Well, you're amazing, of course, and your staff is great. My next question for you is, what is up next for Mr. Aaron Price?
What is up next for little old me?
Yes, little old you.
You know what? Really, I have a lot of projects.
I know, and I want you to just say maybe one of them.
You just had had to remind me. Oh, okay. Well, I work with my homeboy, Mr. Kamani, right here.
Okay,
United. He got some things coming up, so we're definitely gonna get something locked
right,
down.
Right, with Zuba, right?
I have a documentary. It's called Elements. We're going to be following people involved in music culture here in the Twin Cities. So if you are involved in music, please holla at your boy.
See your boy.
What else is going on?
Everything.
I mean, everything. I mean, you know what? And I'm looking forward to the second season of Candy Fresh. I mean,
of course. Can you give us a little bit of what's next for Candy Fresh for the next season, if you know?
You know what? I mean, the first season was full of surprises.
Of course.
So I would assume that the second season will probably be the same.
Just the same, yeah. If not better, right?
Well, you know, it
only gets better than this.
Look at this place. I mean, you know, when we first started Candy Fresh, from when we was in, we're doing auditions in the basement of Bedlam Lower Town.
What?
And we have all these different people, you know, coming together, and they're like, I'm going to be on this show.
Right?
And it was tough. I mean, B, you know, we were sitting over here like, man, who are we going to pick? You know, who is good for this? And it was like, man. But to see how we started out literally in the basement, and then now we're in a TV studio.
Wow, that's amazing. Everyone, please give it up for Mr. Aaron Price, the executive producer of Candy Fresh. Up next, we have Destiny Roberts. She's getting interviewed by Miss Shannon. Thank you so much. This is Candy Fresh.
I'm a classic man.
Candy Fresh got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy Fresh gon' show up, get your shine on.
Ah, yes, the lovely audience here in the Candy Fresh Studios. I am Miss Shannon, your fill-in host for the special anniversary edition of Candy Fresh. Yes. As you see, our normal host is up there on the ones and twos, Miss Brit. So she's so multi-talented that we just said, you know what, could you just throw some music together? She's like, why, yes, I can. I would love to do that. Yes, is right. Right. And you have become accustomed to having fantastic musical performances here on Candy Fresh, and so it is now time for one of them. Give them up for Miss Destiny Roberts here. Okay, the list is long. That's rapper, singer, producer, photographer, fashion designer, everything. Did I miss anything? Oh, wait, you need to talk to the
filmmaker.
Mic.
There we go. I mean, yeah. You guys hear me good? All right, cool.
And you just dropped a new EP in June 2016 called Just a Reminder, right?
Yep, Just a Reminder.
One of the things I noticed about the EP is that you seemed very intentional about how you were picking even like the titles of the track. So what was your motivation when you were coming together with the music for Just a Reminder?
All right, so pretty much Just a Reminder originally started off as like some Black Girl Magic type tape where I try to like encourage women of color to just realize that they're beautiful the way they are and all that kind of stuff. But then I realized it could be a lot bigger. It can be more about like just the culture in general. And so every song, I'm just pretty much reminding you of something, like your worth, that you are perfect the way you are, that you are no less than great, that you're beautiful the way you are and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, that's.
And you actually took it one step farther. Yes, we do have the EP, but you also started basically a clothing line and kind of a, we'll call it a fashion movement to kind of work towards reminding people of how they should present themselves and feel about us. So tell us about that.
Yeah, so pretty much I made this hat. It says Melanin Poppin'. With the album, I just try to take it beyond just it being something you hear, but like you can look at it something every day and be reminded that you're a king, that you're a queen, that your melanin is popping, that your melanin is lit. And it's just everything I'm trying to do, I'm just trying to remind you, you know, daily of things that you don't necessarily get reminded of every day. That's important to hear because we are all amazing people. And I just want you guys to know that.
Everybody give it up for her, please. All right. Now, I know our DJ, Miss Brit, she has your track. And tell me again what the title of the track you're going to perform is.
So I'm about to perform this song called Glow.
All right, everybody, get ready for Destiny Roberts, her backup singer, Aubrey, and Miss Brit as they give you Glow here on Candy Fresh.
It's that Candy Fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city.
Make some noise if you know your melanin is lit. If you know you're beautiful, make some noise.
Light it up, light it up.
Yeah.
Killer with the melanin, a felon then. My melanin adapt to any element. We the kid, call us medicine. Made with honey, brown sugar, and some cinnamon. Elegance, beauty, and intelligence, we killing it. They won't admit it, but they feeling us. Yeah, so go ahead with your band two knots and your till ass head. Let that afro rock. They gon' have something to say about whatever we rock. Regardless, just be you with whatever you got. And don't forget that you so lit. We ain't even playing tag and you so it. But we gotta be a team, fuck a color skin. Come together, team melanin. She a queen, baby, hairs on fleek. Yup, there's nothing better than a melanin lit.
Light it up, light it up.
A melanin lit.
We got the glow, so light it up. A melanin lit.
We just got the, we just got the, we just got the glow. But you already, already know, you know we got the glow. We just got the, we just got the, we just got the glow. But you already, you already know, you know you got the glow. That's the natural light. Keep it real, you the natural type. Melanin popping, so they ask for a bite. But they ain't ready for it. Try to tell them that they gotta go get ready for it. You can throw whatever at us and we steady gone. Yep, and it's just like that. You ain't stopping us. Now all black don't crack. Belly black does crease. Now tell me what you see. I ain't no bad bitch. You can call me queen. Yeah, my locks the crown. Can never stop the brown. You know I'm melanin popping. I say it loud and proud. Yeah, you so lit. I was hoping that you noticed that your glow's lit. You the potion. Oh shit, no, you're golden. You've been chosen. And that's true. All you really gotta do is be you. So light it up, light it up, I'm melanin lit. We got the glow, so light it up, I'm melanin lit. You know we the shit, so light it up, know we lit.
Sing it with us, y'all, just light it up. That's all you gotta sing, y'all ready?
Light it up, light it up, light it up, I'm melanin lit. We got the glow, so light it up, I'm melanin lit. You know we the shit, so light it up. Know we lit, know we lit.
so light it up. Yeah.
Candy Fresh got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on. Candy Fresh gon' show love. Get your shine on. It's that candy.
I am Roxy and we are here at the amazing Candy Fresh 1 year episode. I am so honored to be standing next to the lovely La Vie Boheme. You know, with her amazing band behind her, of course. You look beautiful.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You too.
Thank you.
Just reflecting.
Right? You know? So I want to know, what is up next for you? Because you actually came to Candy Fresh before.
Yeah.
So what's been up since then?
Since I was on Candy Fresh the last time, I have been really, really busy building my brand. Just taking as much time as possible to lay a really strong and firm foundation to launch a lifestyle brand that's going to offer several different products and services, or not services, more so products. So yeah. Live music, concert events, music that you can purchase, yoga classes and workshops that I've been building. So, you know, the brand overall is going to be geared towards helping to people have opportunities to nurture their lives and to just dive in and take care of themselves.
That's amazing. Give it up for that. So I just recently got word that you opened at the Minnesota Zoo for More Day in the Time, right?
Yeah, with me.
That's amazing. How did that feel?
Oh man, it was crazy. The house was so full and I took notes backstage.
Of course,
I just stuck around and just watched. I was really moved by the idea that, you know, they didn't grow into that kind of intentionality in what they're doing. They didn't grow into that.
Right.
They started with that kind of intention behind everything they were doing. I couldn't even tell who was Q and who. I was like, is Morris Q with the band? Is Jelly Bean Q and him? Or like, yeah, it was just tight. It was seamless and, you know, really inspirational.
So what did you learn from that experience?
That they didn't grow into that. That's where they started.
Right, yeah.
From the beginning, they came in, they were like, that's how they had their rehearsals, from the very beginning.
Right.
Not like, well, we got a big show coming up, or this opportunity could come. Yeah.
Wow, so that's amazing.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations to that, because that's something Thank that you put on your resume. That is big.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
With Miss Mina Moore, right? A great opportunity.
So you're going to be performing a couple songs tonight. Can you give us a little bit of inspiration behind the tracks that you'll perform tonight?
Absolutely. So I'm going to do two songs tonight. One is my single, Exits, which is out now. You can get it on iTunes, Google Play, Amazon.com, everywhere. And the other song is called Fly With Me. And Exit just came out of, I mean, it was really kind of a jam session that just kind of evolved. Yeah. And just the idea that getting comfortable being uncomfortable and trying to figure out what is your next step. I know something ain't right. That's all I know right now. Something's not right, so I need to find an exit. I got to get up out of here. I don't know what's going on with y'all over there, but I know I got to go. I do know that. I don't know what y'all doing, but I got to go. And just kind of being comfortable in that in-between space. So that's where inspiration came from.
So if there's a young woman out there watching you tonight, what could you tell her in preparing for her career choice as well?
Listen to your heart. Listen to whatever bothers you about the world, whatever bothers you about other people, that's your charge. What you feel like is missing, that's what you need to be doing. Not criticizing other people if they're doing it or not. So that's what I've been learning over the past, you know, I've been dancing for many years professionally for different dance companies and laying bricks in the foundations of others and, you know, criticizing what I felt was there and what wasn't there. And eventually it was like, I guess I just got to do it.
Right.
I guess I got to do it. I got to show up for myself. So that's what I was saying.
Well, that's amazing. I see you have your band behind you. Would you like to introduce your band really quick?
Yes. I have to my left on bass, Kenneth Garnier. All right, all right. To my right, Mr. Ryan Bynum. And last but certainly not least, Blair Alexander on the drums.
Well, thank you so much. Congratulations on everything that you have going on here. Up next, ladies and gentlemen, La Vie Boheme is going to perform. So get ready for that. I am Roxy, and this is Vie Boheme, and this is Candy Fresh.
candy fresh, got that new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh, come show love, get your shine on. Do da da do da, do da da do da, do da da do da. Do da da do da, do da da do da, do da da do da. I wish you were here with me. I wanna share these moments with you. But there's 800 miles between us. So much to say, I don't know where to start. Seems like we're not on the same page, my love. You hearing me, but I know you not listening. So I'm saying, where's the next exit? Where's the next exit? Where's the next exit? If you lose me, where's the next exit? Where's the next exit? Where's the next exit? Can't find it for the life of me. Can't find it. Can't find it for the life of me. Can't find it for the life of me. Can't find it. Can't find it for the life of me. Where's the next exit? Where's the next exit? Gotta get out of here, can't do this no more. Oh my God, am I really at this event and dude is literally yelling on the mic about peace? How you gonna yell about peace? Yo, excuse me, sir, Mr. Community Vigilante, sir. How people gonna trust your vision when you reckless in your delivery? Girl, I got to go. I'm gonna finish my drink and I'm getting out of here. Seems like we're not on the same page, my love. Hearing me, but I know you not listening, so I'm saying, where's the next exit? Where's the next exit? Where's the next exit? If you lose me, where's the next exit? Where's the next exit? Where's the next exit? Can't find it for the life of me. I can't find it. Can't find it for the life of me. In my own mess, getting on my own nerves. Always a thinking, got to go so I can grow. Won't be drained any longer. Against the grain, I shall go. Won't be drained any longer. Against the grain, I shall go. Next exit. Thank you. I see you looking, I see that you're infatuated, yeah. I see you like what you see. That's cute. I'm gonna reel you in nice and slow. Gonna take my sweet time with you. Come fly with me if you do, baby. Come fly with me if you do, sugar. Come fly with me if you do, baby. Come fly, fly. Come fly with me if you do, baby. Come fly with me if you do, sugar. Come fly with me if you do, baby. Come fly, fly. Wishes of delicious freedoms that seem suspiciously fictitious. Wishes of vicious kisses between the future, Mr. Mrs. Wishes of delicious freedoms that seem suspiciously fictitious. Wishes of vicious kisses between the future, Mr. Mrs. And Paris, Kenya, Belize, Amsterdam, and Japan. Come fly with me if you want or don't. Yeah, I'll ask, but I won't beg, my love. Bring your strength and fear on my trip. Yeah, come fly with me, 'cause I love you, my love. Gonna reel you in
that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up, get your shine on. If that candy fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on, get your shine on. Candy fresh gon' show up, get your shine on.
Celebration.
Right, this is amazing. Thank you so much for watching Candy Fresh. We would like to thank our amazing guests, your original co-hosts, Sonny Brown and Miss Britt, as well as executive producers Aaron Price and Bianca B. Lovely Rhodes.
Give it up! And again, of course, give it up for our amazing performers, Miss Destiny Roberts. And for the amazing V. Boheme.
And please do not forget to give it up for yourselves, this amazing live audience. You guys are amazing. Please follow us through Crown Lens Media Group on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
We hope you enjoyed this special anniversary celebration of Candy Fresh, and we look forward to sharing another year with everyone.
Amen. Yay. And this is Candy Fresh.
Candy Fresh! Candy Fresh! Candy Fresh! Candy Fresh! Candy Fresh! Candy Fresh!
It's that Candy Fresh, got the new now next. If you a dope artist in the city, come on and get your shine on. Get your shine on. Candy Fresh gon' show love.